All right, so let's talk about how you can actually map your keyboard so that someone in your band, or maybe you, could quickly control the tracks in your set to start and stop them or to advance to the next. So you can actually add keyboard shortcuts to your computer keyboard to do this, and it's really easy. In the top right corner of the screen, there's a little button here that says key. You want to turn that on. Now, anything that you see that turns orange can be assigned to any key on your computer keyboard. There's a little yellow button with a keyboard on it that you want to make sure is turned off, because when that's turned on, it's actually telling Ableton Live to use your keyboard as a MIDI controller. Instead, we're wanting to use it as key commands. So let's just turn that off. Now let's click on our first song, and I'm just going to click on one on my keyboard, and you'll see that it assigned the one key to You Make Me Brave. Let's go to This Is Amazing Grace and assign it to two, and Unstoppable God, we're going to assign it to three, and then I'm going to leave key mapping mode, and now it's ready to go. So you could put your computer back by your drummer or your keyboard player, and to start song one, they could just hit one, and it'll start song one. Space bar will kill the track. You can hit button two, start song two. Button three, start song three. That's a quick way to control the tracks in Ableton Live.